Well, first off, just wanted to thank Ron for the opportunity to be here. Like you were saying, it takes a lot of little things to get people to be able to get this to happen, getting out those newsletters, getting out the word, so to speak. And so I just want to thank all the people that actually came together to make this happen so I could just come here and at least talk to all you fun people about what's been going on. What I've found so far in talking to people that have trigeminal neuralgia, and it's the bigger thing, it's not necessarily just trigeminal neuralgia. It's any type of condition of the body that you normally go and see your medical doctor. Is that we have this problem and they give you a diagnosis, well, this is what's wrong with you, but no one ever really explains what's causing the problem. I think, at least in my experience of talking to a lot of people with TN, it's, well, I know I've got this pain, but where did it come from? Most people have no idea where the problems are actually originating in the body. So before I start talking about all the details about what we do and how it can be beneficial for some people with TN, I just want to take a step back and just show a big overview, okay, what's going on? Why do some people have pain that goes up here? Why is it only on one side of the face? Why is it only in my jaw? Just take a bigger step back so everyone knows bigger picture. What exactly is going on inside your own body? Background about me, I am from the West Coast. My mom and dad always said, slow down when you're talking. So if I get flying along and run over something, just throw up a hand or something like that, and then I'll just do the one of these, and I'll try and slow back down. Okay. But again, basic idea, both my parents are teachers. Dad taught high school, going on year 32 right now. Mom taught sixth grade for 29 years, so it was always important for them, and I think hopefully that's where I get it from, and hopefully you'll agree, to explain things in ways that people understand. Okay, so I'm not going to use any kind of big words or anything like that. I want you guys to understand what's going on in your body, and then why some of the procedures are done the way they're done, not just what I'm talking about, but just briefly, the MBD, I forgot glycerol, but the MBD, the gamma knife, why all these things are being done, because maybe no one even sat you down and said, well, why are we trying to do this? And then more importantly, you have to understand, okay, what's going on with me? Why are they trying to do the things that they're trying to do? Or what are some other options? So there's a whole bigger picture of my goal. So we're going to talk about the anatomy and things that are done about it. More about the type of chiropractic that we do, because a lot of different types of chiropractic, so I'm going to go into more detail what it is that we actually do over there in Chesapeake. And then, depending on how many analytical people are here in the world, in the room, we'll see how much detail I need to go into and why what we do might work. If not, we can read about it later. So again, Mike, you're saying, graduated University of California, San Diego, so I'm a little ways from home right now. Started off studying molecular biology. I always, when I was growing up, knew that I wanted to help people. The problem was that about 2 years into my education, I found out that I didn't like looking at test tubes all day long, so I needed to take a step back, work with some bigger pictures. So I've been to a chiropractor when I was about 15 years old or so. My mom was going to see me because I think she had low back pain, neck pain, typical reasons why someone would go and see a chiropractor. And I did see a chiropractor, and I just noticed my posture changed from here, which is the reason why I went initially, up to here. So mom's voice rang out in my head the whole time was, well, maybe you want to be a chiropractor when you grow up. I don't know what my mom says. So I studied molecular biology, and again, it was just too tiny. So I took a step back and said, well, what's the way you can still help people, but a bigger picture? And chiropractic is great because you get to help out people live better lives, let them live better lives themselves. You're not fixing people. People are fixing themselves. To help people live better lives, and more importantly, there's no body fluids. No cutting, no stitching, no sewing, nothing like that. So it worked out pretty well. So when I graduated from Davenport, Iowa, down from San Diego, California, to Davenport, Iowa, that was a little bit of a shock. I had a surfboard actually up on the wall in Davenport. The Mississippi didn't exactly count. And then moved out all the way over here to the East Coast. And even though I'm over here, there are still no waves, so the surfboard is still on the wall. All right, so when you talk again, anatomy, we're going to start off progress right on through here. First thing to know, if most people, like your medical doctor, or you, we go outside this room, we talk to people about if you had any condition in the world, and they started trying to describe to you what your problems are, they say, well, you know what? The number one leading reference medical book for describing human ailments, the human condition, what's wrong with you, is something called Guyton Hall. That is the main textbook. If you want to know what's wrong, it's in there. And it's about 800 pages long, and I just put it up here as an illustration because of Guyton Hall, all 800 pages, one-third of a page is devoted to trigeminal neuralgia. Now, I illustrate this not to show there's a shortcoming here. I'm just saying that this is not a relatively new condition. I've heard from patients that, you know, they've used a lot of people up in the Tower of London
people that have trigeminal neuralgia. And this is not a new condition, but however, the awareness level. And it's great that I heard mention about the dentist who had been to a seminar that had been educated. Hey, I just went to the seminar. There's a thing called trigeminal neuralgia. I actually got it in my education as part of the normal course, but that's a little bit different.
But we get, and it's the awareness is getting up there, but what's actually been known about it overall?
It's about a third of a page out of 800.
So what is the, if a medical doctor, a dentist, someone, even a, you know, just a person at the library wanted to know about trigeminal neuralgia, they looked it up in the Holy Grail reference book, what it says, lanceting, sharp. They like to use big fancy words, but sharp works fine for me. So sharp pain occasionally occurs in some people over one side of the face, and sensory distribution. And we're going to take these words and break them down to what that actually means in English. Pain that occurs in some people on one side of the face in the area where the nerves go. And we're going to talk about where those nerves go. The pain of, and some of you who have known it may not have heard, but they have other words for it, trigeminal neuralgia, particularly in the room. It's another form of saying trigeminal neuralgia. So the pain in the face goes down in the area of the nerves. And whenever we got this problem, the way that we usually try and fix it, according to Guided Hall, is it surgically cutting off the nerve at the source. Usually that's supposed to work. However, furthermore, sometimes that operation is unsuccessful, and I think some people here, unfortunately, might agree with that. Unfortunately, sometimes the operation doesn't work.
Jamie, I don't mean to stop you.
No problem.
The cutting the peripheral, cutting the nerve itself,
yes,
causes pain. It doesn't cure it.
Okay.
And I think what you may want to look at, the like separating the trigeminal nerve from the arteries and veins,
right,
and sealing them off stops the pain.
Right.
For a lot of folks.
And I have that a little bit later.
Oh, okay. But
this is according to their one. This is just
what
he's
reading out of the.
Yeah.
Oh, out of the book.
Yeah. No, this is not me. This is what the community says is going on with trigeminal neuralgia.
Okay.
And so, no, thank you for the clarification. Yeah, there's a big difference between just cutting it and then trying to shield it off.
Oh, okay.
But sometimes, again, the operation is unsuccessful. It doesn't work. Well, why the heck doesn't it work? Well, indicating that the lesion, i.e. problem, indicating that the problem that causes the pain is elsewhere. And where elsewhere is it? Well, it's actually in an area known as the brain stem. And we're going to go over all this a little bit. And this ties directly in with what I'm going to be talking about. But again, a lot of words, big thing. Most of the pain in the face, coming down. In order to fix it, we need to either cut off the sensory portion or at least shield it so that it doesn't get irritated anymore. Unfortunately, even though we may do all that, it doesn't always work. And why in some cases do we think it doesn't work? Well, because there's a problem elsewhere that we didn't know about and we don't know how to fix. That's what's going on as far as walk around the hallway, talk to people. That's what trigeminal neuralgia is. Well, let's start talking bigger picture. Again, most people, unfortunately, I feel sometimes don't know. Well, I know where it hurts, I can point to that, but where does it start at? What gamma knife, where is it going? Why are they MVD? All these different terms that get thrown out there. Well, what bigger picture, what's going on in everyone's body? Because you, me, people out in the hallway, we're all built more or less the same. Okay? My anatomy, my bones, my nerves are more or less the same as yours. So, terms, the origin, where does that nerve start? We gotta know if there's a problem, where does it start, where does it come from? The nerve starts inside our head, and it's gotta get out to our face. So it starts somewhere, it goes out of the bones of the head, and then it distributes, it goes into different areas. Okay, so we're gonna be talking about those different things. The nerve starts somewhere, it's gotta get out, and then once it gets out, it has to go different places. And again, the purpose of this nerve is not to cause all this pain. The purpose of the nerve is to let you feel what's going on in your face. It's to control different muscles in the face, all these different things. The nerve is supposed to be there for sensing things. Unfortunately, things go haywire, and so we're going to go into that. So we've got a lot of pictures coming up here. Where does this thing start? And this does have a laser pointer. Laser. I am colorblind, but I can actually see that. Can everyone else see that? I'm not real big on trying to do high-tech stuff. People throw up a PowerPoint and then just talk at you.